It occurs to me that I've always written about space in one way or another, since many hours of my adolescent years spent looking out from a screen door window upon summer's nights in South Buffalo and longing for a wider world. Thus, perhaps it's hardly a surprise that I keep being drawn to, no pun intended, Agnes Martin's scrupulously inscribed The Harvest from 1965. Here it shows itself in the careful and caring drafting, whereas DIA curator Lynn Cook points out the pencil's, quote, fragile traces of lines, catch only the most protuberant threads of the canvas weave, and the gently hovering ground, the delicately reverberating field. That is, Martin's painting brings to mind the interplay of the smooth and the striated, in which a grid drawn closely enough becomes itself a space rather than measures of one. In Martin's painting, we experience what Cook calls the oscillating figure-ground reversal, in the way that a screen door perhaps becomes a misty space for an adolescent boy. Looking closely at The Harvest, we're tempted to enumerate the grid of small squares, but then we realize that each sector of any number of even sides is itself a square. An almost infinite encadrement of square and squares, eventually including the museum itself and the city around it. The Harvest makes us mindful that the simple placidity of such spaces, what calms us when we doodle in meetings, has its sources in the natural world. As one gets closer to them, rows of corn, for instance, give way beneath the husk to an interlaced, recursive vision of the rows of kernels, while in the world beyond, these same forms repeat themselves in the platted rows of perfectly square Midwest cornfields as viewed from an airplane. Indeed, Martin says about her work that, quote, it's really about the feeling of beauty and freedom that you experience in landscape. And because my wife Carolyn has made this a concern in her artwork, in looking at The Harvest, I think of the interplay of kinetic pattern within the grid of a quilt, whether the tumbling blocks within which an inner pattern begins to flicker like life in the prehistoric swamp, or the more complex, inflected grids of G's Bend vernacular quilting. Martin characterizes the rhythmic succession of such forms as being about, quote, light, lightness, about merging, about formlessness, about breaking down form. Finally, then, there's light itself and how this painting summons, almost in whispers, beneath the news of all else crying to us upon these walls, what Agnes Martin has called the perfection underlying life.